I guess we started with the topic, that is the continental drift theory. So what is the idea of drifting of the continents? The idea of the drifting of the continents is there is change in the climate, right? Plus there is some force that is causing the drifting of the continents. Plus the continents change their position. And because of the continents changing their position, there are changes in relief, geomorphology, mountains, etc. There is changes in magnetic inclination of the rocks. Magnetic inclination means how the magnetic field of the rocks behave. There is a changes in the magnetic inclination of the rocks. Third, there is changes in the climate of an area. Will the past climate change due to continental drift? Will there be changes in the previous climates? If the continent goes from one place to another, will the past climate change or not? Yes, the past climate will change. So when you study the past climate, and how it has changed. Past means ancient, means paleo, and this is we are studying climate. So question agar aata hai, paleo, write a short note on the paleoclimatic evidences or paleoclimates, means you have to show how the climates have changed over the past. You already know the law, that is the only thing permanent is change, and the study of the present day topography is an out of will be studied by when we understand what are the past geomorphic processes that are operating. So present impressions on the relief features gives an idea about the past geomorphic processes. Is climate a part of process? Yes, climate is a part of process. Fine. And when we study the past magnetic inclination, ye thoda difficult hai, it is known as paleomagnetism. Rest of the things you already know, how the position and the relief features have changed, though Wegener kuch relief feature ke baare mein batata nahi. Relief feature has changed means Pangaea got broken into the Gondwana land and the Angara land. Then there was a formation of the Tethys Sea. Uske baad all the continents started drifting westwards and northwards. The westward drift was due to the tidal force. The northward drift was due to the gravitational pull and the law of flotation. Though no force are wrong. Fine, there is no nothing such as this. Uske baad the continents such as Gondwana land further broke into South America, Africa, Madagascar, Australia, Antarctica and Peninsular India. Peninsular India, that is the part which is to the south of Tropic of Cancer. So what is the part of Gondwana land? One shortcut to remember, all the continents which are in the southern hemisphere, Africa ho, South America ho, Antarctica ho, or the Australia ho, plus Peninsular India is the Gondwana land. And then the Angara land or the Laurasia, Laurasia ka dusra name is the Angara land, broke into two parts. What are the two parts of the breaking of the Angara land? That is the North America and the Eurasia. Fine. After that, why the breaking, etc., again don't worry. Wegener ke theory mein we don't understand this, but because of the Wegener's theory, did he give the idea ki how the drift has occurred, or did he give the idea that the continents have moved? Usse pehle what was there? There was a concept of permanency of ocean basins and the continents, means continents and the ocean basins are at the permanent position, but this idea was challenged by the Wegener in the continental drift theory. When he challenged this idea, though he was initially laughed, but I told you there are some of the evidences of the continental drift theory, and due to this evidences we know that continents have moved, continents have drifted. So because of this, scientists could study the continents have drifted. Though Wegener ka wrong point was he could not explain what is the force responsible for the drift, but yes, continents have drifted. And then the force was studied by Arthur Holmes, and he told ki the continents are not drifting due to the tidal force or this any other force, it is drifting due to the convectional currents. हमने एक फोटो देखा है इन विच वी सॉ हाउ हॉट द इंटीरियर ऑफ द अर्थ इज एंड बिकॉज ऑफ द इंटीरियर ऑफ द अर्थ बींग हॉट द हॉट मैग्मा राइजेस अपवर्ड्स अलॉन्ग विद द वाटर वेपर इट हैज इनफ पावर 200 किलोमीटर का थिकनेस है ऑफ मैग्मा सो इमेजिन द 200 किलोमीटर थिक मैग्मा व्हेन इट इज राइजिंग अपवर्ड्स इट इज बींग ब्लॉक्ड बाय द ऊपर का कॉन्टिनेंटल लैंड मास और ओशियनिक क्रस्ट एंड द कॉन्टिनेंटल क्रस्ट इट इज बींग ब्लॉक्ड बाय द क्रस्ट बिकॉज इट इज बींग ब्लॉक्ड बाय द क्रस्ट इट विल गेट डिफ्लेक्टेड एज इट इज गेटिंग कंप्लीटली डिफ्लेक्टेड ओशनिक क्रस्ट विच इज वेरी वेरी थिन 5 kilometers इट इज देन ब्रोकन बाय द convectional currents you will understand this over the period of time but does a vapor which is originating from your boiled water if you cover wo dhak bartan or if you cover that vessel with a lid does the vapor have enough power to displace or move the lid yes vapor can easily move the lid so similarly lid why l that is a dhakkan on the top of a vessel So why that lid can be moved by the vapor, boiling vapor, because lid is very very thin. So crust, can I say, is a dhakkan, and the asthenosphere or magma is the boiling some liquid inside, and that can easily move the lid. So when this thing is happening, convectional currents cause movement of the continents. Then it was studied by seafloor spreading by Harry Hess, and ultimately the continents have moved. And due to the movement of the continents, there are exactly cause-effect mechanism was given by the plate tectonics theory. The most important theory in geomorphology is the plate tectonics theory. Not a single scientist, because though the idea of plate, jo NCERT kehta hai, was given by Morgan McKenzie. Yes, the idea of plate was given, but the tectonics, that is the movement of the plates, was given by numerous scientists and the plate tectonics tells you about earthquakes, tsunami, mountains, relief features, everything that is present on the earth which is based on the interiors of the earth. Then we have regarding the exteriors of the earth, we have Davison Peng jo hum over the period of time karenge. But had there been no Wegener, tell me, had there been no Wegener, so would the idea of drifting of the continents been reality? No. Nobody would have known properly ki ha continents have drifted. We would have still thought ki mountains are formed because of gods, earthquakes are formed due to gods, volcanoes are formed due to gods. But it is the Wegener who gave this idea ki this is the cause and effect mechanism of the formation of the relief features. Fir uske baad, yes. Arctic region. नहीं नहीं पैंजिया का सम पार्ट वॉज इन अंटार्कटिका नॉट एंटायर पैंजिया सो इफ दिस इज द साउथ पोल एंड इफ दिस इज द नॉर्थ पोल दिस इज हाउ द पैंजिया वॉज लोकेटेड दिस एंटायर लैंडमास वॉज पैंजिया या इट वॉज टू सम एक्सटेंट टचिंग द आर्टिक रीजन बट मोस्टली इन द अंटार्कटिका अब क्यू वॉट इज क्वेश्चन इज क्यू बिकॉज उससे पहले के आइडिया हमें पता नहीं We just know कि ये अकेला पैंजिया नहीं है इससे पहले देर वेर 5 times द पैंजिया वॉज फॉर्म्ड एंड डिस्ट्रॉइड सो वेग्नर्स पैंजिया वॉज द 5th पैंजिया उससे पहले देर वेर 4 more पैंजियास एंड दे वेर क्रिएटेड एंड डिस्ट्रॉइड ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम वेग्नर्स पैंजिया वॉज नॉट द 1st पैंजिया बट लिमिटेशन सिर्फ कंप्यूटर बिल्डिंग एंड वेग्नर्स पैंजिया इज नॉट द लास्ट पैंजिया यू हैव सीन इन द एनिमेशन 250 million ईयर्स आफ्टरवर्ड देर विल बी अगेन 1 more पैंजिया हमने एक वीडियो देखा था इन दैट वी हैव सीन एन एनिमेशन की 1 more पैंजिया विल बी क्रिएटेड आफ्टर 250 million ईयर्स सो पैंजिया इज क्रिएटेड एंड डिस्ट्रॉयड गेटिंग इट वी जस्ट स्टडी व्हाट आर दिस सो बिफोर आई कैन स्टार्ट विद द वेग्नर्स कॉन्टिनेंटल ड्रिफ्ट थियरी कैन आई यू टेल मी कि प्लेट टेक्टोनिक्स इज नथिंग बट एन इम्प्रूवमेंट ऑफ कॉन्टिनेंटल ड्रिफ्ट बेसिक आइडिया इज सेम कि द प्लेट्स आर मूविंग सिर्फ कॉन्टिनेंटल ड्रिफ्ट सेज व्हाट डज द प्लेट टेक्टोनिक्स डू It refines the continental drift theory. How does it refine? Force, हाँ, properly बताता है. It is not an original idea. Drifting idea has been taken from the Wegener. The force has been taken from Arthur Holmes. Sea floor spreading idea has been taken from Harry Hess. And बन गया एक after that combined all the ideas, put it in the computer modeling, and we have one very big theory, grand theory, what is known as a plate tectonics theory. Fine, so it is an improvement. So if you look at the past year questions, GS mein poochte hai continental drift. In the optional, I guess agar continental drift comes, it will be very, very easy. So what they ask you in the continental drift in the optional is evidences, fine, or critically analyze. Critically analyze means you should give the negative points and also tell the positive points and come to a conclusion. Or the most common question in optional is how the theory of plate tectonics is an improvement of Wegener, fine. Then next, aajkal jo short note mein they are asking you is this too. Write a short note on paleomagnetism, write a short note on paleoclimatic evidences, paleo past climate, how the past climate has moved over the period of time. Getting it? Fine. So you can take down the drifting, continental drift theory. Introduction. Continental drift theory. This topic will come in a one major topic, the theories of landform development or the formation of Earth's crust. This all will be the part of our syllabus, formation of the Earth's crust. And usme se sabse pehle the continental drift theory. Before we begin to the continental drift theory, some few observations. Where is the major landmass situated, in the northern hemisphere or the southern hemisphere? In the northern hemisphere. But where is the landmass? Where is, at which pole is the land? North pole or south pole? Where is the land? South pole mein there is an Antarctica, north pole mein there is Arctic Ocean, fine. But the major landmass is still in the northern hemisphere. That means, can you go to the Wegener's continental drift theory and see where was Pangaea? Still in the south pole. And upar kuch nahi tha. What his question was, why the Pangaea is not in the Arctic? Because there was nothing in the Arctic. Pangaea was just touching the Arctic. Even today, though the northern hemisphere is full of continents, North Pole is still a water body. Though the southern hemisphere is dominated by the water body, South Pole is the landmass. Kyunki historical arrangement was this, right? Why the historical arrangement was this? Though there is one theory which explains this properly, it is known as tetrahedral hypothesis, but that theory has been rejected, not a part of our syllabus, because except for this, it does not explain anything. I'll just give you what is theory. Wo kehta hai ki Earth is a rotating ball of fire. It started cooling. Because of cooling, there was settling in the different densities. Then the crust also started to cool. As the crust started to cool, crust is divided into two parts, continental crust and the oceanic crust, which is more denser, continental or oceanic crust? Oceanic crust is more denser. So as the oceanic crust started cooling, some part of the oceanic crust collapsed, or continental crust rega at a greater height. Fine. Over the period of time, even the continental crust started cooling. Because the continental crust started cooling, the Earth, instead of being a sphere, this theory says Earth is not round. Instead of being a sphere, it is made up of triangular form. It is triangular in form. And there are some edges of the triangle which are at the top. Matlab, if it has become pyramid, Earth has become like a pyramid. So some part of the pyramid ka top has been exposed, and that top of the pyramid is the continent. Jo part collapse ho gaya, that is the ocean. Kyun hum ye theory nahi kar rahe? It defies everything. Ki Earth aaj bhi pata hai hume is round. Earth is not triangular in shape. So aisi theory karke fayda kya hai? Getting it? Is it Earth triangular in shape? When we see a sphere, is it triangular in shape? Our entire idea of the Earth is based on Earth is sphere. So Earth rotates. Our satellite communication has shown that Earth is round. Earth is not what? Lothian Green says tetrahedral. This is what is a tetrahedron. Wo kehta hai, this part is oceans, jo niche chala gaya. And this part of the continents, fine. But so this is not the case. The permanency of positions. has been challenged by major theories such as continental drift theory, seafloor spreading theory, and the other theories of the landform development, and the other theories of landform development. It has been observed that point number one, there is a more concentration of landmass in northern hemisphere. Bracket में 75% of the landmass, while there is more concentration of water in southern hemisphere. Point number two. Except for Australia and Antarctica. Most of the continents are roughly triangular in shape. Point number three. Majority of the oceans are also triangular in shape. Full stop. Now look. Most of the continents are triangular in shape, roughly triangle, Asia, triangular in shape, obviously not Australia. Ye hai triangular in shape, India. This is triangular in shape, fine, Atlantic Ocean. This is also triangular in shape. If I bring Asia here, yahan pe Asia hai, yaad rakhna. So this is also what is the triangular in shape. And even the Indian Ocean is triangular in shape. Getting it? So how is the ocean triangular in shape? This is the Atlantic Ocean. How is the Pacific Ocean triangular in shape? This is the Pacific Ocean. How is the Indian Ocean triangular in shape? This is the Indian Ocean. How is Asia triangular in shape? This is what is the roughly Asia triangular in shape. this is how is the North America triangular in shape. This is how is the South America triangular in shape. This is how the Africa is triangular in shape. So can you see a major difference here? Dekho, you must have not ever thought in this way. The continents are arranged and the oceans are arranged in such a way, the base of a triangle for the oceans, the base of the triangle here and the base of the triangle for the continents is in the north. But for the oceans, the base of a triangle is in the south. Getting it? Agar triangle hai, and if we are considering ocean as a triangle, uska base is here, this is the apex. On other hand, take any continent, this is the base and this is the apex. Getting it? Fine. So that is the next point. That is, the triangles are arranged in such a manner that for the continents, the base is to the north and apex is to the south. The base is to the north and apex is to the south. And for the oceans, the base is to the south and apex is to the north. Just remember this one word. Humne ye isliye likha hai because you should know one word. This is known as antipodal. Antipoles, ek dusre ke poles are opposite to each other. This is known as an antipodal arrangement of continents and landmass. Antipodal arrangement of the continents and landmass. Continents and water bodies. Ek hi exception hai, kaun sa? Australia. Antarctica bhi dusra exception hai. Why we are not considering Arctic and Antarctic as an ocean separately? Teeni ocean, because naturally there are only three oceans. Fine. 2000 tak there was not even Antarctic Ocean. Then the international community decided to name the water combined of Indian Ocean, Pacific Ocean and the Atlantic Ocean below 60 degrees south as the Antarctic Ocean. Antarctic Ocean was sab koi natural ocean nahi hai. Natural oceans are only three. Fine. Arctic Ocean, somewhat water of Pangaea that has been trapped now in the northern hemisphere, but main three oceans are there. I have given you a very fast overview of the continental drift theory in the previous lecture. Usme bhi we have seen the theory talks only about Panthalassa being reduced in size, forming the Pacific Ocean, westward movement, Atlantic Ocean, northward movement, Indian Ocean. It also explains why the Indian Ocean is closed, because India has gone, Africa has gone to the north and it has collided with the Asia, and hence Indian Ocean is the only ocean that is an example of an closed ocean. Baki these continents have moved westwards and therefore gap has been opened, and therefore Atlantic is open, therefore Pacific is open ocean, but Indian Ocean is enclosed from all the sides. Getting it? So now the continental drift theory. Now take down the introduction. The antipodal arrangement rating, what is antipodal arrangement? comma paleoclimatic evidences paleoclimatic evidences, comma, changes in the relief features, has been explained with numerous theories out of which the most significant one is the concept of continental drift. किसकी पढ़ते हैं हम कॉन्टिनेंटल ड्रिफ्ट थियोरी? वेगनर की. इज इट द फर्स्ट पर्सन? नो. हु इज द फर्स्ट पर्सन? एंटोनियो स्नाइडर. सो दो द कंसेप्ट वॉज इनिशियली गिवन बाय दो द कंसेप्ट वॉज इनिशियली गिवन बाय एंटोनियो दो द कंसेप्ट वॉज इनिशियली गिवन बाय एंटोनियो सिंडर S-I-N-D-E-R, Cinder, comma, F.G. Taylor or Taylor, T-A-Y-L-O-R, F.G. Taylor, 1908 में. ये सब एग्जाम के लिए याद मत रखो, 1908 हो सब. जस्ट रिमेंबर द नेम्स फॉर इंट्रोडक्शन. द मोस्ट प्रॉपर थियरी वॉज गिवन बाय अल्फ्रेड वेगनर. द मोस्ट प्रॉपर थियरी वॉज गिवन बाय प्रोफेसर अल्फ्रेड वेगनर. व्हेन? 1912 and then uska English translation in 1924. So you see so much afterwards Antonio Snyder. So the first person is the Antonio Snyder. But why do we study his theory? Because ye Antonio ne ya F.G. Taylor ne sirf idea diya tha. Idea is giving is very easy. To explain it with the help of scientific theory, ki these are the steps. See, what is the basic difference between idea and a theory? Idea anyone can give. For giving a theory, there has to be cause and effect. It has to be proved. For proving, it has to be based on the universal truth. And then it becomes a theory. So the person who gives the theory is the most important person. And therefore, we study it with the continental drift theory of Alfred Wegener. Fine? Basic premise of the theory. Note down only in the points and exam may be aise likhna. Introduction, then basic idea of the theory or basic premise of the theory. Basic premise means why the theory was given, what were the assumptions in this theory, etc. So, first basic assumption or basic premise is the theory aims to study past climatic changes. I told you Wegener was botanist or climatologist. He was not a geomorphologist. So the theory aims to study past climatic changes, but formed due to drifting of the continents. But due to drifting of the continents. Climates have changed in the past, but why the climates have changed? Because continents' position have changed in the past. Drifting of the continents. देखो हमने ये अभी तीन चार बार किया है. If India was located here, then India went up. So has it drifted? Means drifting means moved. Has it? Yes. So because it has drifted, will it experience this time यहाँ का climate, then here climate, then what is the climate here? And because the climate has changed, the structure of the rocks, will it be same or change? That is what I have made you write. Past climatic changes due to the drifting of the continents. Fine. Second, it assumes that Sial floats on Sima. Sial, silica and aluminium, floats on Sima, silica and magnesium, without any resistance. बाद में what did Wegener told? Remember the day before yesterday's lecture, कि the mountains are formed because Sial has resisting the Sima. And what does he assume? That Sial floats on Sima without any resistance. So क्या है contradictions in his theory, right? Third, according to him, there are two forces which cause the drift. What is the first force? Matlab, write down in sub points. Two forces. So, एक force है. What is causing the westward movement? Tidal force. Two forces which cause the drift. A, tidal force, which cause westward movement of the continents. And B, differential gravitational force. Differential gravitational force. And the force of buoyancy. What is the differential gravitation force and force of buoyancy? It is nothing but the difference between the gravitational force and the force of buoyancy. What is the force of buoyancy? Force of buoyancy is nothing but floating. Anything that when it is thrown in the water, har cheez dubti nahi hai. Some of them float, and that is the buoyancy. Is there any force known as force of buoyancy? No. इट इज जस्ट नथिंग बट फ्लोटिंग, द कंसेप्ट ऑफ फ्लोटिंग. सो सेकेंड फोर्स करके फोर्स ही नहीं है. देयर इज नो थिंग इन द वर्ल्ड विच इज नोन एज फोर्स ऑफ ब्यूएंसी. दैट इज द सेकेंड मिस्टेक. गेटिंग इट? अब इसको कितना कॉम्प्लिकेट बना दिया. दैट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स एंड द फोर्स ऑफ ब्यूएंसी. बट देयर इज नथिंग सच एज फोर्स ऑफ ब्यूएंसी. इफ यू आर थ्रोन इन टू द वॉटर यू विल फ्लोट. Right? Not because your body is putting some force into the water. It is nothing but resistance of the difference in the densities. If iron is thrown in the water, it will not float. Why? Because the mass and density is greater, so it will sink. If sponge is thrown in the water, it will float. If ship is thrown in the water, 9 parts of it will go down, 1 part will float. So there is no force. Getting it? So don't get afraid by what is this word. There is nothing such as force of buoyancy. Force is, it is just buoyancy, matlab floating. Where is the gravitational force maximum on the earth? At the poles or at the equator? Gravitational force sabse zyada. Why? Because gravitational force is inversely proportional to distance. Jitna greater is the distance, utna lesser is the gravitational force. Sun ka gravitational force is more powerful on us or moon ka? Moon ka. Why? Moon is nearer to us. Sun ka is not that powerful. Getting it? So, gravitational force is maximum at the poles. According to him, gravitational force is maximum at the equator. Getting it? But ऐसा इसलिए second करके force है ही नहीं कोई. So इसलिए don't worry. But ये सिर्फ we are writing his theory. We are not critically analyzing his theory. We'll later on critically analyze, but we are writing his theory. So the second force में लिखना. This led to the movement of continents northwards. Movement of continents northwards, that is towards the equator. That is towards the equator. Movement of continents northwards towards the equator. See, he has to prove somehow ki why India mein there is formation of the, yeah, India Brazil mein there is a formation of the glaciated evidence. So he already has known ki India was a part of Pangaea and Pangaea was located at the south. So ab India, how it has gone to the north? He has to prove that. So kaise prove karega? Laga diya gravitational force ki India has been pulled to the north. Africa has been pulled to the north. How, कैसे प्रूव करेगा कि this has opened up? लगा दिया tidal force कि they are moving to the west. But both the forces are not that important. Those who are getting doubt about the gravitational force, see, earth is flat, then it bulges at the equator, and then again the earth is flat. This is how flat bulges at the equator. This is the center of the earth. This is the North Pole and the South Pole, and this is the center. This distance is greater than this distance. Can you understand this? Why? Because the earth is bulging. So because distance increases, gravitational force decreases. Gravity is attraction, and attraction always is based on the distance. Jitna zyada distance, utna matter more gravitational pull. Getting it? Because the earth is bulging. This is how the earth is. We'll study in GS, and you will study in GS irrespective of where the class you are doing. One fact you are going to study, the highest mountain on the earth is Mount Everest, no doubt. But the highest mountain on the earth, when measured from the center of the earth, that is, if you go deep inside the earth, SC matlab core, deep inside the earth. Getting it? अंदर जा रहे हो आप अर्थ के. सो माउंट एवरेस्ट इज लोकेटेड हियर. देयर इज माउंट चिम्बाराजो इन चिली. That is the highest mountain on the earth when measured from deep inside the earth, because it is located exactly on the equator and earth is bulging at the equator. So if you are measuring something, Mount Everest here, this is how the Mount Everest is, and this is how the Mount Chimborazo may be. If you are measuring the height of the mountain from the surface, yes, Mount Everest no doubt is highest. But if you are going 6,400 kilometers deep, and if you are measuring the height of any mountain from here, because earth is bulging at the equator, Mount Chimborazo, which is there, will be the highest mountain. You don't have to worry about these things, because this is so common question which UPSC has asked more than once, indirectly, directly, that when you will start giving prelims ka test series, each and every test series in the market will be asking you this question. Fine. So that is the most common, Mount Chimborazo. Why? Because you are measuring from inside the earth, not from the surface. Similarly, one more question is important. If this is the Mount Everest, if this is there and there is ocean, this is the ocean floor, then highest mountain again from the surface, Mount Everest. Fine. Mount Chimborazo, when you start measuring from deep inside the earth, and I say one of the highest relief feature on the earth is Hawaii Islands. This is 4000 meters deep. This is 8500 meters in height. This is 4000 meters in height. But kahan se? 4000 meters from here, that is from the 0 kilometers. But it is not floating. And if you want to actually measure it, its height becomes 6000 plus 4000. How much exactly is the height? 10,000. So these are small three important points: Mount Everest, Mount Chimborazo and Hawaii Islands. इसीलिए UPSC इतने बार Hawaii Islands के बारे में question पूछता है. They start from the oceans and go up. Getting it? So this is what is the second and first force का, force of buoyancy and the force of this thing. Are this both the forces right or wrong? Wrong. Will we write it here? No. हम सब ये पॉइंट्स लिखेंगे इन द क्रिटिकल एनालिसिस. नो हाउ टू राइट एन आंसर अनलेस इट इज आस्ड कि राइट ओनली द शॉर्टकमिंग्स ऑफ द फोर्सेस. डोंट राइट द शॉर्टकमिंग्स इन द स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट. फर्स्ट यू आर मेकिंग एन आंसर, देन यू विल राइट अ थियरी एंड क्रिटिकली एनालाइज एंड आंसर लेटर ऑन. यूपीएससी विल इधर आस्क यू क्रिटिकली एनालाइज और इधर इट विल आस्क यू एविडेंसेस. फाइन. सो what did this gravitational force do? It caused northward movement of the continents. Fine. Now the gravitational force, I asked you a general knowledge, because he asked a question at the start only. Gravitational force is maximum at the poles, not at the equator. When you see the world map, isliye ek general idea, most of the continents are located in the north pole, while the equator region, whether it is the northern hemisphere or southern hemisphere, has very less continent. This is the equatorial region. Yahan pe it is dominated by water. Why? Because gravitational force is pulling most of the continents to the north. Gravitational force will act more on water or on the land? Land. Getting it? Next. The third, next point, pattern of drift. Pattern of drift. According to the Wegener, drift started in the Carboniferous period, due to the breaking of the major landmass known as Pangaea. Major landmass or known as Pangaea. Which was surrounded by a super ocean known as Panthalassa. सबसे पहले व्हाट वाज देयर अ सुपर कॉन्टिनेंट, क्या नाम था सुपर कॉन्टिनेंट का? पैंजिया. व्हाट वाज द नेम ऑफ दैट कॉन्टिनेंट व्हिच वाज सराउंड द वाटर दैट इज सराउंडिंग द कॉन्टिनेंट? पांथलासा. अब लेट अस लुक एट द थियरी. थियरी पॉइंट नंबर वन, यू हैव सन. बेसिक अजम्पशंस क्या है, बेसिक प्रीमाइस क्या है? सी ऑल फ्लोट्स ऑन सीमा विदाउट रेजिस्टेंस. देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ फोर्सेस. नॉर्थवर्ड के लिए डिफरेंशियल ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स, वेस्टवर्ड के लिए टाइडल फोर्स. नोट्स में हमने इतने डिटेल में लिखा है. इन द एग्जामिनेशन यू विल बी राइटिंग इन वेरी सिंपल मैनर. इंट्रोडक्शन में ही वॉज नॉट द ओरिजिनल, इट वॉज द साइंडर हु गेव हिज थियरी, बट इट वॉज वर्कड अपॉन बाय वेगनर. बेसिक अजम्पशन, सियाल इज फ्लोटिंग ऑन सीमा विदाउट रेजिस्टेंस. सेकेंड पॉइंट, टाइडल फोर्स वेस्टवर्ड्स एंड द ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स नॉर्थवर्ड्स वेयर द टू फोर्सेस रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द ड्रिफ्ट. And directly start with the theory. मतलब इसको भी you will have to reduce in the answer. Fine? So this Sunday, whatever I complete till Friday, we will have a test on Sunday. Fine? Whatever we'll complete till Friday, I guess we'll be able to complete till Davis. Till Friday. Okay. So anyways, क्योंकि वो जो mains वाले हैं वो test लिख ही रहे हैं, तो you also start writing along with them, fine? So, so the theory point number one. There was a supercontinent known as Pangaea. There was a supercontinent known as Pangaea. which broke into the two parts, known as Laurasia or Angara land in the north and Gondwana land in the south. During the Carboniferous period. During the Carboniferous period. Carboniferous period. All clear with this point? So क्या होगा? Supercontinent known as Pangaea. Don't draw this diagram. I'll ask you to make a proper diagram. Now starts the second phase of our preparation. Is how many of you can make world map and the map of India properly? Map of India? Both. World map in 30 seconds. Map of India also in 30 seconds. Fine. So this is what we should be knowing. The third phase of our practice will be map of only North America, map of only South America, map of only the certain continents. Agar zarurat padi to, but that will come in climate. not in this thing. And the fourth phase of our practice will be, when we'll start paper 2, map of only half of peninsular India, map of only northeast India, exactly same name but somewhat like this. Fine. So this, or map of only some part, that is the Kutch region of Gujarat, as the need may be. Fine. So sabse pehle abhi world map. So second point, the phase up of breaking up of the Pangaea, is known as opening up of Tethys, क्यों opening up of Tethys? Tell me someone. What happened? Pangaea broke into two parts, Laurasia land and Angara land. Pangaea, was it surrounded by Panthalassa? Pani. Pani, did it come into the gap? And that gap is known as Tethys. So that is the opening up of Tethys. कोई लिखने की जरूरत नहीं. Means if you already know ki this Tethys Sea was formed due to the breaking up of Pangaea into two parts and water of Panthalassa occupying the gap in between, that is what is the Tethys. Getting it? Understood? Exam में भी लिखने की जरूरत नहीं, notes में भी लिखने की जरूरत नहीं है. That is self understood what is the opening up of Tethys. Point number 3, the continents further broke and drifted apart, For example, the North and South America, drifted westwards. causing the formation of Atlantic Ocean. About, in the brackets if na yaad rakhna, about 50 million years ago Atlantic Ocean was formed. 50 million years ago agar yaad rehta hai then write in the examination, if not you cannot remember then don't write. Atlantic Ocean 50 million years ago. Next paragraph, but the same point. Similarly, the northward drifting of peninsular India and Africa. Which ocean resulted into the formation of Indian Ocean. Same point mein, what happened due to this Tethys Sea? Africa is going northward. What will happen to the Tethys Sea? India is going northward. Will uska size be increasing or reducing? Reducing. So the size of the Tethys Sea, those who are new, the diagram ho chuke hai hamare in the previous lecture. So you again you will understand when we will look at the animation. So right now just try to concentrate. Fine. So the Tethys Sea will be reducing in size. Is the Tethys Sea present today where the India is there? Is Tethys Sea there? No. What is the original Tethys Sea now known as? Mediterranean Sea. Where it is present? Anyone carrying an atlas? So give it to me. Fine. So this is where India was. India started drifting to the north. India is present here. As it started drifting to the north, Africa also started drifting to the north. Australia is also started drifting to the north. But humne likha sirf India and Africa. Beech mein what was there? This was the region of Tethys Sea. What has happened now to the Tethys Sea in the regions jahan pe India is there? Closed. India has filled up that gap. So where is the Tethys Sea now remaining? Between Africa and Eurasia, and today it is known as Mediterranean Sea, which is located at the same latitude as North India, as Himalayas. Tethys Sea are located today at the same latitude as Himalayas, and therefore aage ki theories, ke baad ki theories, the geosyncline theory, and we will study in that. And you already know this, ki Himalayas kisse bane hai? Due to the Tethys Sea. Himalayas have come out of the Tethys Sea. That is, the land of the Tethys Sea has got folded. And then that land came on the top of the water, and that water was compressed, destroyed, and this resulted into the formation of one of the mighty mountains known as Himalayas. Why? Due to the continent collision, plate tectonics. Abhi nahi, but Himalayas came out of the sea. Isiliye today when you go to Kashmir, especially the Leh Ladakh region, or even China, Tibetan plateau region, you will find lakes are there. But surprisingly, in that cold climate, jahan pe the lake should be frozen, jahan pe the lake should be of sweet water, the lakes are saline. Saline water lakes should be present, jahan evaporation is so great, ki water is evaporated and only salt remains. But So Moriri, Pangong So, Urmiki Lake, China, and all the lakes of the Tibetan plateau are extremely saline. Kyu saline? Because that Tethys Sea ka bacha hua pani hai. Caspian Sea, Tethys Sea ka bacha hua pani hai. Right now the controversy is going on whether to declare the Caspian Sea as a lake or as a sea. Fine? But that controversy is not in our syllabus, either in GS or either in optional. So don't worry about that controversy. Black Sea, Mediterranean Sea, what is this? The Tethys Sea. Tethys Sea ka bacha hua pani. Punjab. Kyun fish ke fossils milte hai? Why we find petroleum in Jammu Kashmir to Assam? All this is an example of an Tethys Sea. Fine? Or why the Indian mythology talks about Meru Mandar coming out of Samudra Manthan? Getting it? Tethys Sea. Indian mythology also says the same thing. There was a big snake which was tried to, and then one side mein there is Rakshas, one side mein there is Dev, both are pulling each other, and out of that came the mountain which is known as Meru. Meru mountain, the highest mountain in Indian mythology. Fine? Highest mountain in Chinese mythology came out of Samudra Manthan. So Samudra Manthan wali ye jo idea hai, see, Radha Krishna wali idea is not accepted throughout India. Krishna is accepted, Radha becomes Lakshmi, Rukmini, uska naam change ho jata hai. It is present only in North India because it is a flock, it is a story of this local region. But this Samudra Manthan wali story is present right from Kazakhstan till Indonesia. Not just Indian mythology. Kyu? Mythology is there in ye jo isi region ki mythology thi, but and it has a proof also. That it came out of the Tethys Sea. Fine? Getting it? So this is what has happened to the Indian region. Kuch din mein, yes. Din matlab kuch mil, one lakh years mein gayab ho jayega. That is why that region is still volcanic. Volcanoes are formed when the ocean is compressed by the continents. Alps ki height badh rahi hai. Indian Ocean. Next point. the Gondwana landmass further broke, the Gondwana landmass further broke into South America, comma, Africa, comma, Peninsular India, comma, Madagascar, comma, Australia, as well as Antarctica. In the same point, Australia India and Africa continued moving with different rates. What is the rate of movement of Africa? 3 centimeters per year. North ki taraf move kar raha hai. What is the rate of movement of Australia? Upar ki taraf. Somewhere between, or ye scientific studies se I am telling you. I am not telling you any data jo Wegener ne. This is what has been proved now. 3 centimeters per year, 7 centimeters per year, 18 centimeters per year. Fine? That is why itna jyada distance ye cover kar paya. India. इसीलिए इंडिया हैज मूव्ड विथ सच अ ग्रेट स्पीड टू द नॉर्थ वाइल सबसे धीरे मूव कर रहा है अफ्रीका. गेटिंग इट? अब इंडिया एंड ऑस्ट्रेलिया वेयर द सेम लैंड मास. रिमेंबर दिस वाज द सेम लैंड मास इंडिया एंड ऑस्ट्रेलिया, बट इंडियन पार्ट अब क्यों मूव कर रहा है, दैट इज बियॉन्ड स्कोप ऑफ स्टडीज. मीन्स इट इज बियॉन्ड साइंस ऑल्सो. ये सब अजम्पशंस है, मे बी कन्वेक्शनल करंट्स. रियलिटी नोबडी नोज. फाइन, दिस आर अजम्पशंस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल 200 ईयर्स तक टेट्राहाइड्रल हाइपोथेसिस वॉज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थियरी. आज कोई इसको पढ़ता भी नहीं है. फिर नेक्स्ट 50 ईयर्स के लिए द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थियरी वॉज कॉन्टिनेंटल ड्रिफ्ट. फिर द थियरी बिकेम प्लेट टेक्टोनिक्स. वंस वी विल अंडरस्टैंड आवर मोर थिंग्स द थियरी मे बी प्लेट टेक्टोनिक्स विल ऑल्सो बी रॉन्ग एंड न्यू कंसेप्ट विल कम. फाइन, सो इंडिया एंड ऑस्ट्रेलिया वेर मूविंग, बट विच इज मूविंग विद ग्रेट स्पीड? इंडिया. एंड इसलिए ऑस्ट्रेलिया ब्रोक अपार्ट एंड इंडिया केम अप. But still both are moving at a speed up, which is given in your NCERT as Indian plate tectonics mein we'll study. Fine? ऐसा कुछ नहीं है, बिकॉज जिस प्लेट्स में ओशन डोमिनेंस ज्यादा है लाइक पैसिफिक प्लेट, it may further broke due to hot spots, but rate we don't know why it is causing. Maybe to some extent yes, because they are being subducted very properly, but India is not being subducted. Why India is moving at a great speed we don't know. Up the speed of India has decreased because Asia lag gaya, and today also India is moving northward at the speed of somewhere around 5 to 7 centimeters a year, which results into the increase of height of the Himalayas by 5 centimeters every year. Mount Everest ki height is different in the textbook that has been published 10 years back, is different in the textbooks that has been published 20 years back, will be different in the textbook that will be published 10 years afterwards, because Mount Everest ka height increases by 5 centimeters every year. You push, India is pushing. Fine. हर माउंटेन की नहीं, यंग फोल्ड माउंटेन्स की, मतलब अरावलिस की नहीं बढ़ रही है, क्योंकि प्रोसेस इज देयर. यस, जो जहां जहां एंडोजेनेटिक फोर्सेस डोमिनेटिंग उनकी हाइट बढ़ेगी, वेर एवर द एक्सोजेनेटिक फोर्सेस डोमिनेटिंग उनकी हाइट कम होगी. That is why process and structure both play an important role in the formation of the landforms, not time. Full stop. Where did we, what did we write? Australia and India? Different rates. With Australia occupying its present position in last 300 years, occupying its present position in last 300 years. In last 300 years, next, as the continent's mood the position of the equator and the poles also shifted, which Wegener calls as wandering of the poles, Example, once upon a time, in the Silurian age, bracket mein 350 million years ago, the equator passed through Norway. During the Carboniferous period, the equator passed through South America, North Atlantic Ocean, and Eurasia. No, reality. Equator passed through South America, North Atlantic Ocean, and Eurasia. Full stop. What is the equator? Imaginary line dividing the earth into two hemispheres. Or can I say, forget hemispheres, the imaginary line that divides the center of the sphere. So how can equator change its position? Equator wins. Once upon a time, equator passed through what we have written here. Means they are saying once upon a time the equator, I'll show you. The equator passed through South America, then North Atlantic Ocean and Eurasia. Aisa equator tha. Aise kaise ho sakta hai? Center of the earth to earth hi rahega. And how can equator change the position? Yes, iska matlab equator has not changed the position. this places were at the equator. Now this places have drifted, understood? Equator is the center of the earth, it is still present there. But once upon a time, this part of the world was at the equator, today this is at the equator, fine? Once upon a time, UK, Eurasia was here at the equator. Then it has drifted to the north and occupied this position. So today, India, once upon a time means it was much to the south. If this was at the equator, India was still at the south. All the continents have drifted northwards. And today, this is the original position. And the equator, Joe, the place which was at the equator has drifted to the north. Fine? What did I say? When does the coal form? When the tropical vegetation, that is any kind of a vegetation that is present between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn, goes below huge amount of fresh water and it is buried under pressure, but under the fresh water, river waters. Fine? Which were one of the largest deposits of the coal? The tropical vegetation, okay? So, ye hai Tropic of Cancer, fine? This is where the Tropic of Capricorn is. This are the tropics, getting it? But when Wegener was studying, where did he find the coal deposits in this region? Where did he find the coal deposits? Why did industrial revolution started in England? Because of the discovery of coal. Why Russia was once upon a time such a big superpower? Because Russia is rich in iron ore. Ho sakta hai. But Russia is also extremely rich in coal. Kya hua baad mein? Russia, when it got divided, most of the iron producing regions remained with Russia and coal producing regions went to Ukraine. Isliye to aaj itna dip, why Russia wants to capture the Crimean Peninsula? Why Russia still wants that part of Ukraine? Iron ore hai aapke paas, but if you are not, if there is electricity is not there, what you will do with that iron ore? You will export. So means Russia will become an exporting nation of raw material. If you export the raw material, that is of no use. We have enough cotton. What will happen if you export the cotton? We'll supply it to any country, they will manufacture the clothes and they will sell us that same our cotton but at a higher cost in the terms of shirts. So you should never be the supplier of raw material. Getting it? Ab Russia ke paas coal hai, but iron is there, but coal is with Ukraine. Ukraine is now a member of NATO. And Russia, NATO is because to oppose the Russia. Getting it? So, this region is the region of one of the coal deposits, Purana coal deposits. Itna zyada iron hai Russia mein ki one region of Russia is known as KMA, Kurgs Magnetic Anomaly. Magnetic anomaly means it is so rich in iron ki it looks as if wahan pe magnet chipak jata hai. Fine? इतना ज्यादा कोल है यहाँ पे कि दिस रीजन इज नोन एज कुज बास डोन बास इन रशियन लैंग्वेज एक्सट्रीमली रिच इन कोल राइट बट कोल शुड नॉट बी अबाउ द ट्रॉपिक्स इट इज स्टिल प्रेजेंट अबाउ द ट्रॉपिक्स आयरलैंड में कोल इन दिस रीजन देर इज अ कोल इन दिस रीजन देर इज अ कोल वाई यू गेट एन आंसर देयर दिस वॉज द रीजन वेयर देर वॉज द कार्बोनिफरस इक्वेटर Means all these parts were here. Then South America has drifted and this part has drifted. Getting it? So this is what is known as the change in the equator. Equator has remained at the same, but the places have changed. Getting it? Everyone? Any doubts?
So we also find coal in South America also.
Yes. South America, India, Australia. Antarctica, extremely rich in coal. Whatever mineral you find in India, the same mineral you will find in Australia, the same mineral you will find in Brazil. Getting it? Q? Land is same. Political boundaries are there, but physical, geological properties is same. The reason is क्योंकि इंडिया का जो कोल है इट इज मच न्यू एज कम्पेयर टू द ऑस्ट्रेलिया का कोल जितना ओल्ड द कोल इज देयर कोल कैसे बनता है वेन समथिंग गोज बिलो द फ्रेश वाटर राइट सो इफ ओल्ड कोल इज देयर जो वाटर है इट इज डिस्ट्रॉयड इट इज इवेपोरेटेड जितना न्यू कोल इज देयर देयर इज मोर मॉइस्चर इन इट. सो व्हेन यू बर्न समथिंग व्हिच इज हैविंग अ मॉइस्चर, धुआं ज्यादा निकलेगा, एनर्जी कम मिलेगी. इफ यू बर्न समथिंग व्हिच इज वेरी ओल्ड, जिसमें मॉइस्चर इज नॉट देयर, इट विल नॉट गिव एट ऑल स्मोक, इट विल गिव मोर एनर्जी. द ओल्डर द कोल बेटर इट इज, यंगर द कोल लेस. सो व्हाई इंडिया का कोल, व्हेन डिड कोल फॉर्म, कोल फॉर्मड इन द कार्बोनिफरस पीरियड. वेयर वॉज इंडिया इन द कार्बोनिफरस पीरियड? नॉट एट द इक्वेटर, राइट. एंड जब एंड होने आया कार्बोनिफरस पीरियड, देन कोल स्टार्टेड फॉर्मिंग इन इंडिया, बिकॉज इंडिया केम इन दैट पोजिशन. सो इंडिया का कोल इज जनरली 200 to 300 ईयर्स ओल्डर एज कंपेयर टू द अदर, जो बेस्ट क्वालिटी कोल है. इसलिए इंडिया के कोल में देर इज मोर मॉइस्चर एंड सल्फर. गेटिंग इट? बट that means we do not have anthracite in India. We have bituminous coal in India, which is a second grade coal. Isliye quality of coal is different. Fine? But iron ore, India ka is also one of the best quality iron ore. Australia ka also is one of the best quality iron ore. Fine? What? Yes. Landmass same है, but obviously see if the landmass is same, still इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि हर जगह यूरेनियम means metallic minerals will be distributed equally. इंडिया में कुछ कुछ पार्ट में यूरेनियम है, but इतना ज़्यादा नहीं, because coincidentally यूरेनियम वाला landmass became Australia. फिर भी इंडिया में land और यूरेनियम है. Where? झारखंड, जादूगौड़ा, तुमला पिल्ले, आंध्र प्रदेश, join करो वो ऑस्ट्रेलिया को ज्वाइन हो जाते हैं ईस्टर्न पार्ट, राइट. एंड सी, इंडिया हैज वन ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट यूरेनियम डिपॉजिट्स, ऐसे कहा जाता है, एट नवरापहार इन आंध्र प्रदेश इन तेलंगाना. बट हमारे पास टेक्नोलॉजी नहीं है फॉर सच डीप माइनिंग. सो टेक्नोलॉजी, बिकॉज वी डोंट हैव, वी व्हेन वी डोंट हैव टेक्नोलॉजी, वी इन्वाइट द प्राइवेट प्लेयर्स. Example, you see, metro is built by PWD or L&T? L&T. Why? Because PWD does not have the same technology. Once you become an engineer in PWD, will you be going to attending seminars, doing research? Nahin. Government officers will get stuck in the jobs, file pass karne mein. Fine? So there is no technological upgradation. But private players are having new technologies. They have money. Fine? So the same thing applies here. There is enough uranium, but we do not have technology. And but because uranium is used in nuclear energy, we cannot invite private players and do uranium mining in India. Otherwise, we have invited private players in coal. We have invited private players in iron ore. We have invited private players in natural gas mining, except for uranium. Why? Sensitive material. Uranium Corporation India Limited has only the authority, monopoly hai. And when there is monopoly, there is no competition. When there is no competition, kya farak padta hai? Getting it? NSG ka member ban jata hai? India kabhi nahi karega, kyunki foreign players aayenge. टेक्नोलॉजी मिलेगी हमें, बट इंडिया कभी नहीं करेगा. क्यों नहीं करेगा? फॉरेन प्लेयर आया, कर दिया माइनिंग, और फिर से भोपाल गैस ट्रेजेडी जैसा कोई ट्रेजेडी हुई तो क्या करोगे? दैट इज व्हाई नो प्राइवेट प्लेयर्स इन न्यूक्लियर. एनएसजी का और उसका टोटली अलग है. गेटिंग इट? नेक्स्ट. सो जीएस में ये सब नहीं लिखते हम, वॉन्डरिंग ऑफ द पोल्स, ओपनिंग अप ऑफ द टेथिस. ऑप्शनल का आंसर विल बी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम जीएस का आंसर ओनली बाय दिस कीवर्ड्स. फाइन, वॉन्डरिंग ऑफ द पोल्स एक्सेट्रा. लीव सम डायग्राम, बिकॉज ये डायग्राम हमें बनाना है. कैन यू मेक द वर्ल्ड मैप? सो मेक इट नाउ. देखो पहले कैसे बनता है आपसे. There is a very, very small technique. Look at the way I am drawing. I start from North America. I take it up, पीछे पीछे थोड़ा ऊपर, then I come down, stop, then I go it bit here, then I take this and stop here. Fine. अब अगर नीचे से if you try to go up, map हमेशा खराब बनेगा. Then you start from here. Make a C. एक दो तीन. Make another C. Make the Gulf of Florida. And take it down and then come downwards. And this is the map of North and South America. Fine. Second step is make a C. Thoda upar se. Come down. Go up. Horn of Africa. Make India. Malaya Peninsula, South China Sea, and then go up. Stop, come back to this region. Itna detail ki zarurat nahi. Make up Europe, go inside, make Eurasia, and then take it directly here. Then make Japan, then give the finishing touches, Sumatra, जावा बाली पापुआ न्यू गिनिया बोर्नियो ऑस्ट्रेलिया इज वेरी इजी न्यूजीलैंड मैप ज्यादा अच्छा दिखेगा इफ यू मेक श्रीलंका इफ यू मेक मैडगास्कर इफ यू मेक ग्रीनलैंड एंड आइसलैंड फाइन सो दिस इज द मैप ऑफ द वर्ल्ड You'll have to practice it again and again. The more you try to show the relief features, your map will be more distorted. Jitna ho sake, make straight lines. If you don't use the technique which I tell you, map aise banega. If you use the technique, first is maybe tomorrow I'll give you a printout of outline of map of India and the world, small isme, because you do not have luxury, though even if the map is very good, you do not have luxury of making this big map in the exam. Fine? Because your space will be this much in the exam. Margins. This will be the, your map should be this much. Maximum. So, that I will, I have that. And you just ye karo, uske upar tracing karo. Once you do the tracing, your maps will be very easy. Fine. You should know this year, for the first time, मतलब हमें पता चला है केस, इफ यू राइट एवर इन द मार्जिन्स, मीन्स हमें क्या आदत होती है, दिस इज द मार्जिन ऑफ यूपीएससी, वी कीप ऑन राइटिंग एन आंसर एंड रादर देन टर्निंग द पेज हम थोड़े थोड़े वर्ड्स इस मार्जिन में लिख देते हैं, एंड यू शुड नेवर डू इट. वी हैव एन वहां पे लिखा है यूपीएससी ने स्पेसिफिकली कि यू शुड नेवर राइट इन द मार्जिन, अदरवाइज नेगेटिव मार्किंग विल बी गिवन. एंड वी हैव दिस ईयर अ पर्सन हु हैज गॉट नेगेटिव मार्किंग में माइनस 36 मार्क्स इन द मेंस, एंड ही मिस्ड हिज सिलेक्शन बाय 12 मार्क्स. फाइन, सो ही हैज द ही शुड बाय ओरिजिनल मार्क्स ही शुड हैव गॉट IRS, राइट, वहां पे लिखा है. फिर रेड इसमें लिखा है माइनस 36 ड्यू टू नेगेटिव मार्किंग एंड इज फाइनल टोटल. Once you finish this, you should draw from here this as a reference point. ओल्ड इक्वेटर कार्बोनिफरस, उसके बाद टर्शियरी पीरियड केम जब हिमालयस बने थे, सो दैट इज द ब्लू कलर लाइन. सो डू वी फाइंड टर्शियरी इक्वेटर पासिंग थ्रू रीजन जहां पे हिमालयस है, राइट? सो इन जनरल स्टडीज, नॉट इन ऑप्शनल, यू विल फाइंड, यू विल स्टडी टर्शियरी कोल इज फाउंड इन हिमालयस. गेटिंग इट? व्हाई? बिकॉज द इक्वेटर वॉज दैट टाइम नियर द हिमालयस. एक प्लेस भी आप याद रखोगे, नामचिक नामफुक इन अरुणाचल प्रदेश, टर्शरी कोल, दैट इज द कोल दैट वॉज फॉर्म्ड इन द टर्शरी पीरियड. एंड देन दिस इज द प्रेजेंट डे इक्वेटर. सो दिस शोज हाउ द कॉन्टिनेंट्स हैव मूव्ड नॉर्थवर्ड्स. आगे जाके इक्वेटर विल बी स्टिल बिलो. इक्वेटर का पोजीशन हैज नॉट चेंज्ड मच इन साउथ अमेरिका, जितना इन एशिया, बिकॉज वेगनर सेज नॉर्थ एंड साउथ अमेरिका आर मूविंग वेस्टवर्ड्स, एशिया एंड अफ्रीका इज मूविंग नॉर्थवर्ड्स. सो जो द कॉन्टिनेंट विच इज मूविंग नॉर्थवर्ड्स, उसमें द इक्वेटर का पोजीशन इज गोइंग टू चेंज. फाइन, फाइन विद दिस? नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, thus the drifting of the continents, thus the drifting of the continents ultimately gave rise to the present day arrangement of the continents. Drifting of the continents ultimately gave rise to the present day arrangement of the continents. Mention this also in the exam. Gave rise to present day arrangement of the continents. Next point. According to the Wegener, the edges of westward moving continents were crumpled crumple matlab jhuriyan padna, that is wrinkles, were crumpled to give rise to fold mountains such as Andes and Rockies. To give rise to fold mountains such as Andes and Rockies due to the resistance of Sima. ठीक है, westward moving continents का तो उसने बता दिया, Rockies and Andes. But problem क्या है? What is this first assumption we have written? Sial floats on Sima without resistance. और अब क्या? What is saying? The Rockies and Andes were formed due to the resistance of Sima. Were crumbled to form Andes and Rockies due to the resistance of Sima. किसको resist किया Sima ने? Sial को. So in first assumption he says Sial is floating on Sima without resistance. Or jab usko mountain explain karna hai, when he wants to tell that how the mountains are forming, he then says ki there was resistance. So this is not science na, ye to arts ho gaya fir, that is changing the theory as he wants. Science is cause and effect properly, fine. So that is why this is the first major flaw. Second major flaw usi point mein, similarly island arcs of Indonesia, Malaysia, Japan, ये जो islands है which are arc like in shape, they are known as island arcs of Indonesia, Malaysia, Japan were formed because of differential rates of continental drift. ये सब एग्जाम में लिखने का इतना स्कोप नहीं है, सो ट्राई टू यूज द इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड्स, डिफरेंशियल रेट्स ऑफ कॉन्टिनेंटल ड्रिफ्ट. Differential rate of continental drift means continents sometimes drifted at a very slow rate, suddenly they started drifting at a fast rate. So kuch part piche reh gaya, some part jo piche reh gaya they ban gaye Sri Lanka. India was drifting, fir India ka speed change ho gaya, India ka kabhi kabhi speed bahut bada, to ek part toot ke reh gaya, that became Sri Lanka. North and South America were drifting and suddenly they started drifting at a fast rate, so jo pooch uski piche reh gayi, that became West Indies. Fine. अफ्रीका वॉज ड्रिफ्टिंग, जो पार्ट उसका टूट के पीछे रह गया वो रह गया मैडगास्कर. अगेन मतलब कुछ तो प्रूव करने के लिए कुछ भी बनाना, ऐसा है ये वेगनर की थियरी. फाइन, कि गाड़ी जा रही है, सडनली एक्सीलेटर दबाया तो पीछे धुआं रह गया, वो बन गए आइलैंड्स. फाइन, सो दिस इज नॉट अ पार्ट प्रॉपरली एक्सप्लेन. सो दिस आर द सेकेंड मेजर फ्लॉज. आइलैंड आर्क्स क्यू? बिकॉज दिस आर आर्क लाइक इन शेप. सी, फाइन, प्लेट टेक्टोनिक थियरी एक्सप्लेन्स दिस. व्हाट आर द फेमस आइलैंड आर्क्स इन द वर्ल्ड? जस्ट योर जीके, कैरिबियन आइलैंड्स. फाइन, क्यूबा से लेके एंटायर वेस्ट इंडीज क्रिकेट टीम. सेकेंड आइलैंड आर्क इंडोनेशिया, ये वाला पूरा रीजन. थर्ड इंपॉर्टेंट आइलैंड आर्क फिलीपींस. फोर्थ इंपॉर्टेंट आइलैंड आर्क जापान. श्रीलंका इज नॉट एन आइलैंड आर्क बिकॉज इट इज जस्ट एन आइलैंड. आइलैंड आर्क आर ग्रुप ऑफ आइलैंड्स विच आर आर्क लाइक इन शेप. आइसलैंड इज ऑल्सो नॉट एन आइलैंड आर्क. मीन्स इमेजिन, अकॉर्डिंग टू वेगनर, ग्रीनलैंड जा रहा है, सडनली वन पार्ट ऑफ आइस ग्रीनलैंड वेंट वेरी फास्ट, पीछे टूट के वन पार्ट रह गया, एंड दैट इज आइसलैंड. दैट इज वॉट ही मेंट. सो इतना सब लिखने से अच्छा, इफ यू नो द की वर्ड डिफरेंशियल रेट्स, योर पॉइंट इज डन. फाइन, दैट इज वॉट वेगनर सेज. ऑल दिस हैव बिकॉज द आइलैंड्स आर मूविंग एट डिफरेंट स्पीड, तो टूट के रह गया. प्लेट टेक्टोनिक्स सेज दिस आइलैंड आर्क्स आर हॉट स्पॉट्स. विल स्टडी दिस इन plate tectonics, or they are due to ocean convergence. Plate tectonics will give an answer, not this one. Fine, so this is his theory. So what, tell me, what are the criticisms you will be writing? Khud hi socho criticism. All the assumptions of his theory are wrong. Fine, aise forces nahi hai. Second, Sial is floating on sima without resistance. Kyun? Niche kisi ne lubrication dala hai. इट इज ऑयल है एंड इट इज फ्लोटिंग विदाउट रेजिस्टेंस, ऐसे हो ही नहीं सकता. फाइन, नाउ द कंसेप्ट इज सियाल इज नॉट फ्लोटिंग ऑन सीमा. नाउ द कंसेप्ट इज लिथोस्फियर फ्लोट्स ऑन एस्थेनोस्फियर. देर इज नो कंसेप्ट ऑफ सियाल एंड सीमा. सियाल एंड सीमा इज सेम प्लेट्स, एंड दिस प्लेट्स आर लिथोस्फियर, एंड दिस लिथोस्फियर फ्लोट्स ऑन एस्थेनोस्फियर. किसने बताया ये? प्लेट टेक्टोनिक्स थियरी. फाइन, वॉट इज द सेकेंड प्रॉब्लम ऑफ हिज थियरी? See how casually we have written ki India is moving westwards, Australia is moving westwards, northwards, the North and South America is moving westward. What you call as a science? What is the difference between humanities and science? Science mein sabse pehle there is a step by step analysis of the facts based on universal truth. Means if the law of gravitation applies at India, it should apply at each and every part of the world. That is what is a science. Fine? Arts is democracy applies in India, democracy applies in USA, but what is democracy is very, very forget India. Democracy applies in India, but democracy applies in India means rule of the people, but rule of the people depends upon whether you are Ambani or whether you are a politician or whether you are a common man. That is what is arts. Fine? Science mein aise nahi hai. Will the gravitational force differentiate? Nahi, ye poor aadmi hai, main iske sar pe zor se girunga. And he is rich, so no, I will dheere se sit on. So that is not there. This is not present in his theory. Ye pehle kaun sa? Why? Why India moved with greater speed? Why Africa moved in this particular direction only? Fine? These are the flaws in his theory. So first, we'll write criticism of his theory. When you study the criticisms first, and then write the positive points, you will be able to relate it much better. Fine? So the first criticism. Is, initially Wegener assumes that Sial floats on Sima without resistance. Initially, Wegener assumes that Sial floats on Sima without resistance. But later on in his theory says that mountains are formed. Due to resistance of Sial over Sima. due to resistance of CL over CMA. Fine. Thus, there are contradictions in his theory. Second point, inadequate forces applied. In this you write, the tidal force and the force of buoyancy cannot properly explain the drift, अब सी, टाइडल फोर्स मेक, डज इट कॉज ड्रिफ्टिंग ऑफ द कॉन्टिनेंट्स? यस, कॉन्टिनेंट्स को हिला सकता है ड्रिफ्टिंग, दैट इज द, दे मे कॉज ड्रिफ्टिंग ऑफ द कॉन्टिनेंट्स. द फोर्स विच इज गोइंग टू कॉज हाई टाइड्स एंड लो टाइड्स मे पुल द कॉन्टिनेंट्स, प्रोवाइडेड द टाइडल फोर्स इज 10,000 million टाइम्स स्ट्रॉन्गर दैन द प्रेजेंट डे फोर्स, देन ओनली इट विल कॉज ड्रिफ्टिंग. बट इफ यू अज्यूम कि हाँ मे बी उस समय हो सकता है टाइडल फोर्स 10,000 million टाइम्स स्ट्रॉन्गर, सो अगर इतना ज्यादा स्ट्रॉन्गर फोर्स होता टाइडल 10,000 million टाइम्स, तो अर्थ का रोटेशन ही रुक जाता, अर्थ जाके कोलाइड होता टू मून. टाइडल फोर्स इज प्राइमरली ड्यू टू मून. फाइन, सो टाइडल फोर्स इज देयर, दैट इज अगेन आई टेल यू ड्यूरिंग अमावस्या एंड पूर्णिमा ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स ऑफ मून ऑन द अर्थ इज वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग, इसीलिए पानी ऊपर चला जाता है, दैट इज विल कॉल दिस एज हाई टाइड्स. बट कभी लैंड, आदमी ऊपर नहीं जाता टुवर्ड्स द मून. उस आदमी को खींचने के लिए, फॉर समवन टू पुल द मैन और टू माउंटेन टुवर्ड्स इटसेल्फ, द टाइडल फोर्स शुड बी 10,000 million टाइम्स स्ट्रॉन्गर, नॉट व्हाट इज प्रेजेंट टुडे. फाइन, सो उसमें, उस पॉइंट में सब पॉइंट, द टाइडल फोर्स इज हाईली इनएडिक्वेट, the tidal force is highly inadequate for westward drifting of the continents, for the westward drifting of the continents, and similarly the force of buoyancy and the gravity, is also very weak. Force of buoyancy and gravity is also very weak. Next point. Wegener could not properly explain the direction and the time of drift. Time, direction and the proper time of the drifting of the continents, Understood? He could not tell you the sequence, ki pehle kya hua, baad mein kya hua. Next point, when does this theory start? Carbonic first period, that is the biggest criticism. Wegener could not explain why drifting started only in the Carboniferous period. Or in other words, could not explain the trigger mechanism. Could not explain the trigger mechanism. Kuch to trigger hona chahiye. When something, some event should have occurred, that is what is the trigger mechanism. Trigger mechanism that caused breaking up of Pangaea. That caused breaking up of Pangaea in the Carboniferous period. Pangaea in the Carboniferous period. Yes. Yes, mantle plume se. Aur mantle plume se kya? Continents nahi tootenge. Ocean mein crust tootega. Isliye next theory is sea floor spreading. Because what the Pangaea was, it was having numerous islands also. It was not just one solid body. Solid body would not have cracked. There were numerous islands. Those cracked. That became the tethys. Getting it? And the last point. Even the evidences, such as jigsaw fit of the continents, such as jigsaw. So I told you, what is the jigsaw fit? In dono ko join kar lo. That is what is known as the jigsaw fit. Jigsaw fit of the continents, or the distribution of fossils, have some limitations. Next paragraph. Therefore, Wegener's continental drift theory. See, now how many times you will write the same word continental drift in the examination? Only once. The only difference is when you write continental drift theory, ek bar pura likho. And then in the bracket write CDT, and then you can use the word CDT entirely in the paper, in that answer. But ek bar likhna hai tumhe. Similarly, economics mein, International Monetary Fund, you will have to write it once, and then bracket mein IMF. Remember this trick, even in GS also, otherwise you will be writing the same words again and again. But kaun sa shortcut likhna hai? Only which are internationally accepted, right? Aisa nahi ki your own shortcut, ND likh diya New Delhi ke liye. No, right? So, Wegener's continental drift theory earned more criticism, or suffered more criticism than the praise, not earned. Suffered more criticism than the praises, than the praise. Next is the positives or the evidences. What is the biggest positive of his theory? The biggest evidences, not the positive. Means the first is jigsaw fit. Your answer should start with the jigsaw fit. That is the most important evidence. Amisha means when you write anything, you have to write in the order of their importance. Fine. The first is jigsaw fit of the continents. Jigsaw fit of the continents. So the evidences have proved, the evidences have proved that the continents on the either side of the Atlantic Ocean, continents on the either side of the Atlantic Ocean, continents on the either side of the Atlantic Ocean exactly fit into each other. Continents on the either side of the Atlantic Ocean exactly fit into each other. Which means that these continents were once together. You can draw this diagram. And if your drawing skills are good, then only you can draw the next, which I am drawing. Choice is yours. Getting it? North America, Africa, South America. This all were once together. इसलिए ऐसा shape है North America का. This is what is meant by jigsaw fit of the continents. ये तो ड्रॉ करना ही है. दिस तो इवन गिवन इन योर एनसीईआरटी. ये तो जीएस में भी ड्रॉ करना है. द क्वेश्चन कम्स. इन द सेम पॉइंट कैन आई कंटिन्यू. अहमद एंड कृष्णा have proved these are the two important geographers. Ahmed and Krishna have proved that southern India and western Australia, southern India and western Australia, were once united to form a single landmass. Second evidence. Understood this jigsaw fit? They fit into each other. Second evidence. What is the geological evidence? In the same diagram we have drawn earlier, right? Just mark the way I am marking. अगर ये बनाया है तो ही मार्क करना, अदरवाइज कोई जरूरत नहीं. अदरवाइज दिस इज इनफ. व्हाट इज द सेम रॉक्स, जहां जहां रेड कलर है बोथ द रॉक्स आर सेम. Second evidence is presence of same rocks. On the either side of Atlantic. Presence of same rocks on the either side of Atlantic. Similarly, the mountains of, no need of this diagram, I'm just telling you what does this point means. The mountains of Appalachians कहाँ पे, Appalachian mountains North America USA में, mountains of Appalachians are similar to the mountains of Ireland. Where is Ireland? England. And mountains of Scandinavia or Norway. मतलब नॉर्थ अमेरिका ये का ये माउंटेन Appalachian is similar to the mountain of Ireland and the Scandinavian mountains. Why? Because this was once upon a time a single mountain and this was all together. Fine. Now the continents have drifted apart. Beech mein is thousands of kilometers of Atlantic Ocean, and we will study it later on that Appalachians are rich in coal. So obviously Ireland is also rich in coal. Sweden, Scandinavia is also rich in coal. Kyunki mountains wohi hai. Fine. This was all together once. Next point. Distribution of fossils. The rocks of South America. Africa, Peninsular India, Australia and Antarctica have the fossils of Glossopetris. Glossopetris क्या है? Fern, a tree, a small plant, a fern. Fern is a very small plant. Fine, full stop. इससे क्या पता लगता है? There can be tiger in Russia, there can be tiger in India. What is big thing in it? This is not tiger, this is plant. Plant, unlike animals, cannot migrate. इट कैन जस्ट एक्सपांड. हाउ इट कैन एक्सपांड? ये प्लांट है, उसका पोलन्स आर कैरिड बाय द विंड एंड फॉल्स नियर बाय. इट ग्रोज देयर. व्हेन इट इज कैरिड बाय द विंड इट फॉल्स नियर बाय, विच मीन्स साउथ अमेरिका, अफ्रीका, इंडिया, ऑस्ट्रेलिया एंड अंटार्क्टिका, दिस ऑल वेयर वंस अ सिंगल लैंड मास मीन्स गोंडवाना. देन ओनली द ट्री कैन प्रोपोगेट. ट्री कैनॉट प्रोपोगेट इफ देर इज इंडियन ओशन. ट्री विल इट ग्रो इन द वॉटर? Will it grow in the ocean? No. It can propagate only on the land. That means if this entire region, see this is the region of where Glossopetris flora is found. This entire region. Today climate is different. Today their position is different. Means the tree which is present in India, the same fossil is found in Antarctica, which is so many kilometers, lakhs of kilometers away. How it is possible? इसका मतलब ये सब एक साथ थे. अदरवाइज पोलर रीजन अंटार्कटिका, सब ट्रॉपिकल रीजन इंडिया एंड ऑस्ट्रेलिया, इक्वेटोरियल रीजन अफ्रीका एंड साउथ अमेरिका. क्लाइमेट इज डिफरेंट बट ट्री का फॉसिल इज, प्लांट का फॉसिल इज सेम. नॉट पॉसिबल, विच मीन्स वंस अपॉन अ टाइम दिस वॉज कंटिन्यूड एंड सब में एक ही क्लाइमेट था. वाई? बिकॉज दे वर प्रेजेंट नियर एट द सेम लैटिट्यूड्स. फाइन, दिस इज द बिगेस्ट एविडेंस. This is the biggest evidence which tells which tells that continents were once united to in tells that continents were once united in the form of the Gondwana landmass. Once united in the form of Gondwana landmass. Fine. Similarly, there are numerous zoological evidences. Tree hai to ye botanical evidence hai, right? Similarly, there are numerous zoological evidences. Zoological evidences. Including the behavior of lemmings, including the behavior of lemmings, which have tendency to migrate westwards. Whenever there is increase in the population. Whenever there is increase in their population. In their population. Understand what are lemmings? Lemmings are very small rat-like animals or rats of Scandinavia. Fine, this region. How is this coast? Norway ka coast is somewhat like this. Means this is Norway ka end and suddenly there is a huge mountain and uske baad there is a sea. Kyun? Glaciers ne erode kiya hai landmass ko. Now whenever the lemmings का पॉपुलेशन इंक्रीजेस, दे आर नोन फॉर मास सुसाइड. एक्चुअली इट इज नॉट मास सुसाइड. व्हाट हैपेंस? दिस लेमिंग्स थिंक दैट हाउ पॉपुलेशन हैज इंक्रीज्ड, सो दे विल माइग्रेट सो दैट बिकॉज द लैंड मास इज स्टिल देयर एंड वी विल गो एंड सेटल इन कैनेडा. बट व्हाट दे हैव नॉट रियलाइज्ड इज दैट वॉज मच मच अर्लियर. अब कुछ नहीं है. सो दे स्टार्ट माइग्रेटिंग इन ग्रुप्स. रैट है, huge groups mein they migrate and suddenly jab khai aati hai aur valley comes, the first batch falls into the sea and die. Right, so that is one of the evidence. But hame likhne ka itna scope nahi. But have you understood why we have written? Kyu? Ki this is what the lemmings do. Why? Because abhi tak it is conditioned ki ha maybe there is a space there, वे आर नॉट दैट इंटेलिजेंट एज ह्यूमन बींग्स. सो उनके मेमोरी में अभी तक आया नहीं कि अब स्पेस खत्म है. सिमिलरली स्मॉलर एनिमल्स जब भी आग लगती है अफ्रीका में, दे डू नॉट नेवर रन टू द ईस्ट, दे ऑलवेज रन टू द वेस्ट. आज भी ऐसा लगता है कि कॉन्टिनेंट्स हैव जॉइंट टुगेदर. फाइन, सो वी विल कंटिन्यू टुमारो देन. मॉनसून, मॉनसून इज बेस्ड ऑन न्यूमरस फैक्टर्स. अभी तो एक फैक्टर इज पोल्यूशन एंड ग्लोबल वार्मिंग.